So, as we were dissecting the neck, we came across two sets of superficial structures which we decided to show right now itself, because as we go further into the neck, these structures will be removed and therefore we will not be able to show them. The first thing which I would like to draw your attention to is this layer of tissue that I picked up here, this one. This, if you look very closely, you'll find some muscle fibers, very thin muscle fibers, these brownish colored structures here. This is the platysma. The platysma is a subcutaneous muscle which extends from the chin. It interlaces with the muscles of the chin and it descends down like this in a fan-shaped fashion all the way, and it comes down all the way on both the sides and it merges and with the deep fascia of the deltoid muscle as well as the pectoralis muscle. So this is these fibers that you see, these are the platysma. This is a subcutaneous muscle and this is the one which is responsible for keeping the skin of the neck taut. And when I lift this further, you will find just under the platysma, there are some fatty structures. This is also part of the superficial fascia. So this, surgically speaking, the platysma and the fatty layer, all of this together comes under the superficial fascia. And therefore, when we are repairing any incisions on the neck or we are doing any suturing of the neck, we consider these two layers as together and we suture them together. Because if we do not repair the platysma separately, apart from the skin, then the scar will be a very ugly scar. So this is about the platysma and the superficial fascia, which is shown here. The next thing which I would like to draw your attention to is, after I have reflected this, we can see numerous nerve fibers descending down. And I will show a few of them. This is one set of nerve fibers coming down. These are another set of nerve fibers. Yet some more, and when I lift this up, we can see yet many more nerve fibers. These are all the nerve fibers which are coming from the cervical plexus, from under the posterior border of the sternocleidomastoid. These are the supraclavicular nerve fibers. The supraclavicular nerve fibers, root value is C3-4, and they come down and they supply the skin over the anterior upper part of the chest wall and the upper part of the shoulder. So usually when they come down, the textbooks describe them as coming down in three groups: a medial, intermediate, and a lateral group. But here we cannot see the individual groups, but we can see the fibers, multiple fibers of the nerve. When these supraclavicular nerves pass down, they pierce the platysma, because initially they are located under the platysma, and they pierce the platysma and then they supply the skin in this region. So this is about the supraclavicular nerves. So these supraclavicular nerve fibers have got certain clinical correlations. One is, as they're descending over the clavicle, in rare cases, they can even penetrate through the clavicle. And in clavicular fractures, one or more of these nerve fibers can be injured and there can be areas of anesthesia. The next point about this supraclavicular nerve is that this is the cause of referred pain. Whenever there's any irritation on the undersurface of the diaphragm, diaphragm is supplied by C3-4-5 phrenic nerve, and that causes referred pain to the ipsilateral shoulder, and that is by supraclavicular nerve with a root value of C3-4. That is another important point about the supraclavicular nerves. The interesting thing about the supraclavicular nerve is, as I said, the root value is C3-4. So therefore, they supply the skin of the upper part of the chest. Now, if you were to take a look at the dermatome of the chest, we notice that the dermatome is till C4, and after that the next dermatome is T2, and then it continues down sequentially as T3-4-5. So what happens to the in-between dermatomes C5-6-7-8 and T1? Well, these are the five dermatomes which are pulled by the developing limb bud, and they become the brachial plexus, and that is the reason why we have the dermatome of C4. Thereafter, immediately after that, we have the dermatome of T2. And this C4 dermatome is provided by the supraclavicular nerve. So that is yet another point about the supraclavicular nerve which I wanted to show you. And before I go out of this, I wanted to mention one more point. All these veins that we can see here, these are all the superficial veins of the neck which we shall describe later on. And these were all situated in the superficial fascia. And the superficial fascia has been removed, part of which can be seen here. This is the platysma. Cut portion of the platysma that we can see here. The other portion of the platysma was below here, which has been removed. And these nerves were also in the superficial fascia, namely the supraclavicular nerves and various other nerves, which are all located in the superficial fascia, which has been removed. So that is about the superficial fascia of the neck. And before I conclude, this is the trapezius, the descending fibers of the trapezius that we have dissected out, and we can see a facial layer covering the trapezius. This is the investing layer of the deep cervical fascia. And we can see that this is the deep cervical fascia, and the supraclavicular nerves are superficial to that because they are in the superficial fascia. So this is the investing layer. And yet, when we dissect a little deeper, we notice that these are the muscles which forming the floor of the lateral cervical region, and they are covered by yet one more fascia, and that is the prevertebral layer, and that is the prevertebral layer of the deep cervical fascia that is here. However, we have not dissected more here. As we dissect further, we will see them more clearly. So these are the structures which I wanted to show you in this superficial dissection. Thank you very much for watching. Dr. Sanjoy Sanyal signing out. Have a nice day.